Welcome to Mantos Live, recorded in front of a live audience. We're at the Brink Lounge, 701 East Washington Avenue, right down the hill from the Capitol Building in Madison, Wisconsin. We're your hosts. I'm Mary Gaines, and this is Chris Wagoner.
Thank you for coming tonight. As a musician, entertainer, and international educator, Mr. Robert One Man Johnson has spent most of the last three decades in the Middle East and Far East, released 11 recordings, appeared on NPR's A Prairie Home Companion five times, and opened for a who's who of national blues and rock artists. And now he's here to play for you. Thank you for coming here tonight, Mr. Robert One Man Johnson.
Thank you. Baby, put your pretty little hand in mine. Baby, put your pretty little hand in mine. We'll live our life together. Every day will be sweet sunshine. Now I take you to the movies. I might even pay your way. We'll buy some popcorn and I'll kiss your blues away. We'll sit up in the balcony and pitch a little woo. We don't need no instructions, 'cause we know what we should do, baby. Put your pretty little hand in mine. We're gonna live our life together. Every day will be sweet sunshine. If it's you and me alone, instead of sitting around here wishing, we should build a happy home. We'll live the life we're loving, love the life we live, kissing and a hugging, giving all we have to give, baby. Put your pretty little hand in mine. Let's live this life together. Thank you so very much.
Mr. Robert One Man Johnson.
Thank you so much. Well, I'm glad to be here in Madison. It's been a long time. I used to come around here quite a bit in the 70s and 80s, yep. but then we started living overseas and didn't get much chance to get back to Madison. Town's changed a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
A little less snow this year, it seems like, huh? Wow.
So you're based in Iowa City now, but you actually kind of came up here in, you were born in Wisconsin, right?
Yeah, I'm born in Wisconsin Rapids, Wisconsin.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
And then my family moved up to Rhinelander when I was about two, I guess. And then I graduated Rhinelander High School, went to school at University of Wisconsin, Eau Claire, got my degree there, And then met a wonderful woman from Iowa City, and suddenly I'm a Hawkeye instead of a Badger, just like that. The magic of the Big Ten, you know?
Yeah. And you guys have been married, I did my arithmetic, just about 40 years last year, right?
Yeah, 40 years ago.
All right. That's awesome.
40 years with a musician is some sort of record, I believe, is it?
We always joke about it because we each married musicians. You know, we go, what the hell were we thinking? We need to adopt an adult with a day job. That's what we need to do. But for those of you listening out there and maybe not watching video of some sort, Robert One Man Johnson is called One Man for a very good reason. If you thought he was with a band, no, he's not. He is the band. And this pedal, the bass thing is extraordinary. It's I think some of the audience can't quite make it out, but it's parts of a piano. It looks like organ pedals, but you fashioned this whole thing yourself, right?
Yeah, I made it. This is number 14. I made my first one shortly after listening to Jesse Fuller, the Lone Cat, who wrote the San Francisco Bay Blues. He appeared at a little coffee house I was running in Eau Claire back in 1966, and I thought that would be something I would like to do. And first started out with a sort of an electronic foot bass unit, but I wasn't satisfied with the sound, so I built a gigantic acoustic one that went into a huge packing crate, and United Airlines managed to crush it when I was on my way to play in Chicago. And so I started researching how to make them smaller, more portable, and a little bit, hardy.
Yeah.
And so this is the one I like best right now. I've got a couple more that I'm working on, but there are different sizes and shapes and stuff.
It sounds great. It's really interesting. So it's actually, are the bass strings or piano strings?
I use electric guitar, bass guitar, round wound strings. Okay. I find that they work better. I have to cut the ends off them and do some kind of handwork with them, but it seems to work. I think the scale length on this one is about 31 inches or something like that.
Yeah. Hey, would you mind
sure.
playing that just by itself for a second? Right.
It's just kind of I've envisioned it as sort of like a percussion instrument, like a kick drum with 12 notes to it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And sometimes I get a feeling like I'm playing bass lines, and I try to think like Willie Dixon might be playing with Muddy Waters or something like that. But the point is, it's a counterpoint to this cymbal over here, so that's the way it works.
You've probably been doing this for so long, so you probably may not remember when the transition happened, but how long did it take you to like get all that together? Was it difficult?
It was quite difficult. It took him a long time, and as I'm fond of mentioning, my wife endured some pretty horrible repetitive practice moments. But eventually I got so that I feel comfortable with it. It's the first thing to do is I wanted just to play the root notes. Then I played the root and the five. I don't read music, so that's all I know how to say. And then I started making up different patterns for different styles of music and trying to feature it a little bit. And my newest album, which I just finished up, the guy that did the recording did a great job of making sure that it was prominent, which is something that I always wanted it to be a prominent part of the mix.
So it's Dangerous Curves. It just came out, 2013.
Yeah, right? Brand new. Yeah, it's called Soft Shoulders. Dangerous Curves. Yeah. I'll do that one a little bit later.
Okay.
I play that on the metal body guitar. So let me do a little tune called The Flusteration Blues. I got a phone call interview the other, and a guy asked me, he said, do you play the same kind of music as you used to 40 years ago? And I said, no, music has changed for me a little bit. It kind of functions around getting older, infirmity, and also the fact that after 40 years, I still don't understand the mind of a woman, or my wife especially. And so I made this one up for all the guys. It's called Flusteration Blues. Sometimes she says yes when she really means no. Sometimes she says stop when she really means go, man, go. She got me so confused, I got the frustration blues. She says come on over here when she really means please stay away. It's so unnerving, I never know what she's gonna say. Got the flusteration blues. Talk is cheap. Now, honey, have you heard when it comes?
comes to making love, inaction is louder than words. Sometimes she will, and then she won't. Sometimes she says, do that again, and then she says, don't, baby, don't, baby, don't. She got me so confused, got the flusteration blues. Rejection with love and affection, you give a poor boy the blues. Sometimes she says, uh-uh, honey, and then she says, all right, and then she says, slow down, daddy, we got all night. She got me so confused, I got the flusteration, and I'm filled with consternation. I got the flusteration blues.
Is that on your album of the same name? Is that on Flusteration?
Yeah, that's from an album I did about 5 years ago, I guess. Yeah. It was. I recorded part of it in America and part of it in Japan.
Yeah.
So how was it? Obviously, you probably performed in these other countries. We've got Turkey, Japan, Saudi Arabia, China, and Thailand.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's an interesting thing. When we first moved to Istanbul in 1983, my thought was I was going to have to buy Turkish instruments and try to learn how to play Turkish music, but it was exactly the opposite. As soon as I got to town, people wanted to hear what I had to say and what I played. They wanted to hear the blues especially, and they all wanted to play their kind of styles. And so I met an incredible guitarist named Erkan Oğur, who's a fretless guitar player. He plays like, instead of an oud, he plays electric guitar with no frets on it. And he played on it. I had a great time everywhere I went, finding musicians to work with and that were interested in my music. And so I did a bunch of recordings in Istanbul and Japan and around, you know. Bangkok was our last posting, and I played a bunch of clubs there. I didn't get to do any recording with anybody, but I did play with a lot of musicians.
Now, you were overseas. What were you teaching?
I taught middle school language arts to students learning English for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
My wife is an art teacher who taught photography and all the various media of arts. And so we traveled around and wherever we could find those jobs in accredited American high school systems, but abroad. So it was pretty neat.
You spent in that fairly long stretch that you were all over the place. You spent only 4 of those years back here, right?
So we came back for a couple of years. I did my MA in linguistics at the University of Iowa, and then came back another time, and I did worked for the University of Iowa with some sort of Japanese student exchange program for a while, but. Basically, we were gone for 28 years, I think, wasn't it, Marge?
Wow.
Something like that.
Was it culture shock at all coming back?
The biggest culture shock, of course, is not going over there. It's coming back to the States after you've been gone. You walk back, and it really isn't an adaptation to try to come back to America after being gone so long. But we figured it out. We're happily retired now for the last couple of years and just loving it, living in Iowa City and traveling around a little bit in the States.
Before I forget, because we have, I think, some of the same friends in Western Wisconsin, Eau Claire area, et cetera, but Erkan we've known for a while. Actually, we don't know him personally, but we were introduced to him. Did you bring him back? Because he was here, right?
He came and lived with us for a while in Iowa City, and we introduced him to the music scene in Iowa City, and then after that, he went out, played in New York a little bit for a while, and now he's extremely famous throughout Europe and has some wonderful albums, and if you ever feel like exploring something you've never seen before on your YouTube channel, Erkan, Erkan Oğur, is one of the greatest, most unique guitarists in the world.
Totally, scalloped fret or fretless.
It was
electric.
Like a 7-string, wasn't it?
He's got all kinds.
That's the only one I remember sort of like about in Eau Claire.
Indian Santana.
Right.
Sorry. Yeah, just very.
Like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
But we're here with Mr. Robert One Man Johnson here tonight. And you can go if you want to find out more about him. House Dog Music, I believe, is the website. House Dog Music.
That's it. www.housedogmusic.com, I guess, is how we do that. Well, as I mentioned before, I do these songs that have to do with different kinds of situations in my life. And this is one, it's on the new album, and I kind of have fun with it at age 70 now. I've sort of collected a list of all the infirmities that I've encountered. In fact, not even all of them, but some of them. And so I made up this song about hypochondria, and I want to share this with you for sure. I got arthritis, I got chronic bronchitis, I got tingling fingers from acute tendonitis, I got nighttime acid reflux, heartburn and indigestion, I'm squirting stuff in my nostrils for the sinus congestion. I'm a hypochondriac, it's true, but I could never get sick of you. Well, my stomach feels funny, could be diverticulitis. My nose is all runny, yep, allergic rhinitis. My toenail is swollen from a fungal infection. My blood pressure is rising from the hypertension. I'm a hypochondriac, it's true, but I could never get sick of you. Well, I went to the doctor, and the doctor said, son, you appear to be a pretty sickly son of a gun. Think that diagnosis, it's all in your mind. It's my prognosis that you're gonna be fine. Well, I'm up all night with affairs of the prostate. I try to be patient, but the equipment won't cooperate. Carpal tunnel syndrome, it's a pain in the wrist. It hurts to play the guitar, I can't even make a fist. I'm a hypochondriac, it's true, but I could never get sick of you. Well, my friend said, chill, brother, I got a plan. There's a little blue pill that's gonna make you a man. Romantic attraction, keep you up all night. A little bit of love and gonna make you feel right. Got a pain in my shoulder, could be my rotator cuff. It sucks to get older, enough is enough. No coffee, no carbs, no beer, no booze. So many bottles of pills, I don't know which ones to choose. I'm a hypochondriac, it's true, but I could never get sick of you. Yeah, I'm a hypochondriac, it's true, but I could never get sick of you. Hypochondria.
Just do another one?
Oh, yeah, okay. Let me change harmonicas here. I got one that I like a lot. It's called Put Your Money Where Your Mouth Is. And I made this one up. A British friend of mine, I realized that he had completely different expressions. They were almost the same as what we use, but slightly different. So, for example, we would say somebody gave us a dirty look, he'd say somebody gave him a filthy look. And so that was one of his expressions. But the one I liked especially was his little daughter, he would say, give us a kiss. You know, not give me a kiss, give us a kiss. And I thought that was kind of a neat statement. So I made this little tune up here. Love was free. You can prove it now. Give your love to me and put your money where your mouth is. Give us a little kiss. Those lips look warm and tasty on a nasty night like this. Love was strong. Come a little bit closer and give me some shelter from the storm. Give me money where your mouth is. Give us a little kiss. Those lips look warm and tender on a nasty night like this. Thank you so much.
Yeah. You've been on Garrison Keillor's show on Prairie Home Companion on National Public Radio 5 times, and it's great to hear. You know, I know there's been a lot of speculation over the last 10 years or so. It's like, man, when is this guy going to retire? I was really glad to hear him kind of come out not too long ago and say, you know, I think I'll just kind of keep doing this as long as I can. You know, it's just the kind of the way I am.
What is interesting you'd mention that Garrison is a month younger than I am. So, just be aware.
Well, he's a man of words, too. I mean, he loves the stories, obviously. So you guys must have really hit it off. I mean, the stories that you tell, I mean, where you've been, he must have been really enamored of that.
Well, I don't know. You know, he started playing my very first album that I made in 1976 on his morning radio program at 6 till 7 in the morning. It was the original Prairie Home Companion.
Oh, okay.
Was really kind of for farmers getting up to milk their cows almost, you know. later on, I got booked onto the show, and over the years, I did... like I said, 5 shows, but it has been a while since I've had contact with him, and hopefully he can. I sent him the copy of the new disc, and hopefully he'll have me back on.
I bet
nice.
He will. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I'm kind of hoping that when I get to your age, I'll be that good.
Yeah.
Same with Garrison Keillor.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Well, when I was doing this coffee house thing and Jesse Fuller came to town to play in Eau Claire, he was 70 at that particular point, and he had just driven from Oakland, California, all the way to Eau Claire, Wisconsin, sleeping in the back of his Nash Rambler with his all his equipment and foot piano and everything there. And like I said, he was 70 at the time, and he was just a very vibrant performer. He only lived for about maybe 6 years more, I think, after that, and I'm hoping I can beat his record for sure. But one of the stories I tell people is that Jesse was on stage at our little club, which is just a little storefront place down on Water Street, and he was on stage trying to make his presentation, and a guy in the audience, a true fan who knew all of his repertoire, everything he'd ever done, kept yelling out songs for Jesse to play, and he meant it as a compliment, but of course, any musician gets on stage, they want to play the song they want to play when they want to play it, or they maybe already have a set list made up, what they want to do. And this guy was kind of bothering Jesse, and finally Jesse turned over to him, and he looked at him, he said, "I ain't no monkey on a stick." And that phrase, that pointed phrase stuck with me for a real long time, and I think it was almost 20 years later I wrote a song called "I Ain't No Monkey on a Stick," and that's the one I'd like to do for you next, cool. If it's okay. And I kind of was trying for a kind of a calliope, kind of a circus kind of a feeling. So. I ain't no monkey on a stick. I ain't no puppet on a string. You snap your fingers and expect me to jump. I ain't about to do no such thing. I ain't no monkey on a stick. I ain't no lion in the zoo. I ain't no dancing bear on your chain. What is up with you? 'Cause you're living in a dream, trying to fit me in your scheme. Like I've already stated, I won't be manipulated. I got no trouble with my self-esteem. I ain't no monkey on a stick. I ain't no parrot in a cage. I ain't no prancing poodle on your leash, no actor on your stage. Trying to be the boss, throwing stones in a house of glass. I ain't no monkey on a stick. I ain't no monkey on a stick. The situation is making me sick. I ain't no monkey on a stick. I ain't no monkey on a stick.
Yeah.
That was good. I know we've all had those feelings at times. And I've never come up with something that was... I usually just keep my mouth shut because I can't think of anything polite to say.
Well, actually, I get along real well with my wife. So you know that song was just for the general ethos of the world. Yeah.
Sure, mm-hmm. Yeah.
And she's sitting right here in the front row, too. So
that's right. I ain't scared.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, I was playing music in a bar in Rhinelander, Wisconsin. One night, a guy came in sitting at the end of the bar, and he was watching me play, and he sat there for quite a while, and then I took a break. He went out to his car, and he came back in, and he gave me this guitar and said, here, take it, man. Enjoy.
Was that Craig Stites?
It was Craig Stites, yeah. Is it really? So you know the story, yeah, yeah. Well, I tell this story wherever I go because it's kind of a tribute, a humanity tribute. I mean, people don't do that sort of stuff, but Craig did, and I've kept in touch with him and emailed him, and I went up to Rhinelander for my 52nd high school reunion and booked a gig at the local bar called Sackett's Bar and Grill in Rhinelander, and there comes Craig, who I hadn't seen in 30-some years. And we talked and chatted and hugged and shook hands, and I showed him that the guitar was still rocking, you know. So it's a third neck on it, and it's been crushed by the airlines on the way to Japan and repaired and everything. But for a while, it was a headless instrument with tuners at the bottom. It's been through a lot of different things, but it's one of those true gifts that you don't want to part with, for sure. So you tell Craig you've seen me play, and I mentioned his name, all right? I hope so. Yeah, he took a bunch of pictures. We never get them. Anyway, I'll do this one for you. Once again, a song about getting older. I'm starting to get a little follically challenged myself. Looking around the room, and there's more than one person. And then, of course, with age comes the waistline, the burgeoning waistline. And so I'm not sure where this line came, but it came to me, and the song came to me very easily and very quickly, one of those songs that sort of writes itself, and it's called Thin on Top and Thick in the Middle. It's a sing-along, and you don't have to fit either one of those demographics to sing this song. Pretty simple. See if you can pick up on it and join me, all right? Change, the features start to rearrange. The question is, when does this stop? I'm getting thick in the middle and thin on top. Thin on top, thick in the middle. We used to have a lot, but now there's not much more than a little. I used to have a little around the middle, but now there's quite a lot. In the middle and thin on top. Every morning in the mirror, the direct effect of food and beer. I exercise until I drop. I'm thick in the middle and thin on top. Thin on top and thick in the middle. We used to have a lot, but now there's not much more than a little. I used to have a little around the middle, but now there's quite a lot. I'm thick in the middle and thin on top. Now Father Time, he isn't fair. He erased my waist, now he's taking my hair. But I'll keep moving until I drop. Though I'm thick in the middle and thin on top. On top, thick in the middle.
there's not much more than a little. I used to have a little around the middle, but now there's quite a lot. I'm thick in the middle and thin on top.
See, I for some reason, I thought that you didn't have a lot of hair and actually was growing back, because we'd never met before.
So yeah.
It's all in perspective. So we, years ago, it was the early 90s, I think we first learned about you. We used to play in a band called The Common Faces. We'd play down in Iowa City a lot at the Sanctuary. Mm-hmm. And we just stopped back there fairly recently. We were playing with our friend Whitney Mann and ran into you at Downtown Bill's. Really neat venue down there, opening for the Fairlings, a wonderful Iowa City band, and you were sitting in the back row, and we'd never met, but for some reason, I sat down next to you, and I had something, maybe I'd seen your picture or something, but I was like, is that Robert One Man Johnson? I literally, and I think I asked you.
Yeah.
And you said, yeah.
He was whispering in my ear for quite a while.
That's Robert One Man Johnson. I think, ask him. She was like, ask him.
Well, it definitely was serendipitous, because it's really great to be here in Madison and playing with you guys.
Yeah, so thank you. Well, thank you for coming.
Thanks for coming, yeah.
Really wonderful.
Anyway, have I got time for a couple more?
Absolutely, you bet.
All right, good. The lights do things to metal guitars. You know?
The airline seems to have a thing. They've got something out for you.
Yeah. I think I'm closer. Well, this one I made up is called With or Without. It's a song about relationships, and I'm starting to get a theme going here. My wife is going to say, what's going on here? But I, when I selected these songs tonight, I had a kind of a sort of an idea in mind. When I first wrote this song, I wrote it actually from a feminine standpoint, and I recorded it. And I was hoping that Bonnie Raitt might consider doing it. So, you know, I wrote it as a song a woman would sing. And then I didn't hear anything about that, so I said, well, heck with that, I'll sing it. So I changed it back to a masculine viewpoint, that, you know, it's all just got to do with pronouns. And then I figured, well, wait a minute. And so I changed it to either way. I mean, I just changed the pronouns. So this is for anybody. You can't live with them. You can't live without. They make you want to tear your hair. They make you want to jump and shout. You believe you ought to leave. You can't live with them. You can't live without. Now it hurts when you're together, and it hurts when you're apart. You know you're in for nasty weather. You're gonna end up with a broken heart. But there's something about that impetuous pout. When you can't live with them, you can't live without. It's unreal. How do they always gain control? inside of your soul. You hate it when you're with them, but you miss them when they're gone. It's hard to understand this, but the love just goes on and on and on. Mass confusion, that's what it's all about. When you can't live with them, you can't live without. Fight for independence, but you feel like a slave. When they wrap those arms around you, you're gonna end up in the grave. Masochism, that's what it's all about. When you can't live with them, can't live without. Can't live without them, huh?
We've got time for one more.
Oh, yeah. We mentioned Bonnie Raitt. You wrote that for Bonnie. You've opened for a lot of interesting people.
Including
Bonnie Raitt,
her, yeah.
Including her, Dr. John, Muddy Waters, Dave Van Ronk, Leon Redbone, Mose Allison. Just bought a Mose Allison album the other day that I've had. Captain Beefheart, John Prine, the list goes on. Another one, Corky Siegel. We're here, and you did a nice interview today with our friend Jim Schwall, who's in the audience here. And Jim, from the Siegel Schwall Band, and has his show For the Sake of the Song on WORT 89.9 here. But Corky, how do you know Corky?
Well, I got my booking agent hooked me up, and I did must have been 20 jobs with him, all the way out to the Pacific Northwest, and I played with him a bunch of times in Chicago area and also Milwaukee around. Yeah. So. Quite a few times I've had a chance to work with Corky, and I was telling Jim today I thought it was pretty strange that we had never met before, but finally did.
Yeah.
It's good. Yeah, great. Had a good interview this morning with him, and it's great to see him show up for the gig.
Yeah, and then hit the road. Yeah. You have, I must have some amazing road stories. You go to housedogmusic.com. Poetry, you've got some interesting poetry on there, and of course, great stories from your trips. They're all not even road stories. They're just you're there. It's from your residencies and
I've collected the stuff I write is just little short pieces, but I kind of wanted to share some of the things that Marge and I experienced all these years, and there've been some unusual situations that we've come across, and I just posted a couple more today, as a matter of fact, and I like to write poems, although my poems often turn into songs.
Yeah.
I don't usually write standalone poems. I communicate with my friend Mitch Leroux, who's from Madison. He writes poetry, and we send each other poems every once in a while and stuff. But like I said, I start a poem, and somehow or another, it usually ends up just being a song. You know?
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's the way it is.
You do that sometimes? You then take those lyrics and say, you hear a melody, and I just set it to music.
Yeah, can't stop it. It seems to be a kind of a addictive sort of thing, you know.
Yeah.
Like them just stand alone as poetry, but they end up feeling like a song.
Yeah.
Do you think you'd ever publish a book that had all your lyrics and poems in it?
Nah.
Y'all should definitely go to the website, housedogmusic.com. You can find out also discography, a whole bunch of albums from 1976 on. Chevrolet Panel Truck Blues was a very popular one early on. Soft Shoulders, Dangerous Curves, the new one just out in 2013, is available hard copy And also, you obviously can download it online.
People are starting to download it. I just got a friend of mine in Japan just wrote me. He said he downloaded it. Yeah. Another person in Taiwan and stuff like that. So hopefully, you know, I mean, people don't buy CDs so much anymore.
Yeah.
Although I do have 9 of them for sale here tonight, you know,
great.
If you're interested and all. But I did want to play as a final song,
yes,
the title song, Soft Shoulders and Dangerous Curves.
Okay.
Can I just tell the little story behind it?
Yeah, please.
Yeah.
Please.
I was driving from Eau Claire, Wisconsin to play a gig in Duluth, and this is a true story. I reckon it was right up by Rice Lake or something. The road crew was doing some work on the highway, and they'd put these two signs up. The top one said Soft Shoulders, and the one underneath said Dangerous Curves.
That's too good.
And what could I do, you know?
Yeah.
It only took about, I reckon it only took about 30, 40 minutes for me to get this tune.
Well, you needed to, because there are other songwriters probably right.
There's one behind you, one in front of you.
Anyway, I got to it first. Was going to say, I like playing blues on this guitar. It's made for the blues. But, you know, for years I played five-string banjo. And so in open G tuning, I often resort to those kind of banjo licks. And so it seemed appropriate for this particular song to put in a kind of a banjo lick. On my mind and working at my nerves, cause all those highway signs, they remind me of her, thinking about those soft shoulders and dangerous curves. All alone and lonesome, rolling down the road, back home in Wisconsin, I know it's freezing cold. Here in Louisiana, my rig is running right. Lord, I'd love to lay with her tonight. On my mind and working at my nerves, all those highway signs remind me of her, thinking about those soft shoulders and dangerous curves. I just passed a driver in a no-passing zone, my mind so disconnected from these hours all alone. If baby was here with me, she could set me straight. 2 more days, boys, I can hardly wait. Eating on my mind and working at my nerves, and all those highway signs remind me of her, thinking about those soft shoulders and dangerous curves. Snapping, trying to stay awake. I think I better exit here and have a coffee break. Yellow flashers indicate a detour up ahead. I wished I was home laying in my bed. Next to those soft shoulders and dangerous curves, eating on my mind and working at my nerves, cause all those highway signs, they remind me of her. Think about those soft shoulders and those dangerous curves. Lights are flashing, horns are honking like a stock car race. In my mind, my memory is fixed upon her face. Traffic on this interstate about to make me cry, but a northbound sign's reflected in my eye. Thinking about those soft shoulders and dangerous curves eating on my mind and working at my nerves, cause all those highway signs remind me of her. Think about those soft shoulders and those dangerous curves. Thanks, folks. Thank you very much.
Mr. Robert One Man Johnson.
Thank you kindly.
Go to housedogmusic.com. His new CD, Soft Shoulders, Dangerous Curves. You can find out how to get a hold of that there.
That's right. We'd like to give special thanks to Andy LaValle from Bear Sound, our technical producer and recording engineer, Taylor Ryan, our audio intern and front of house engineer, Kyle Austin, our video intern, Alice Dusler, our camera operator, The Brink Lounge, WORT 89.9 FM, and thanks for listening.